So we have this wonderful relationship. When a ball rolls down a hill, the distance it rolls, and I tried to mark off equal distances here, excuse my terrible drawing, but the distance the ball rolls is somehow proportional to the square of the time. I say proportional to and not equals, because remember, we don't know the units of time or distance, in fact. Time was measured by allowing water to flow and then weighing the resulting water. And one distance unit was just defined as the distance a ball rolled in one time unit. Okay, so we have this relationship. What can we do with it? Well, it reminds me a little bit of what we saw from Aristotle earlier in the unit. Aristotle thought that all objects fell at constant velocity, and that that velocity was proportional to the mass. The way we used this relationship was to set up ratios. So if we have two objects, 1 and 2, with masses 1 and 2, and some velocities that we're assuming are proportional to that mass, we can set up this equation. And if we happen to know three of these quantities, so maybe two masses and one velocity, we can figure out the unknown quantity. Okay, not so bad. But what does this square do? How does that change the calculation? Well, initially, the setup looks just the same as before. The only difference is now we have to square this side. Pretty straightforward. Let's practice. We have two identical balls, which will number 1 and 2. I let this first ball fall for 2 seconds, and it falls a distance of 20 meters. If I let this ball fall for 7 seconds, how many meters will it fall? And you can use this equation and enter your answer here.